Allegiance of Islam to Abraham, the source of all monotheisms, through his son Ishmael.
رب العالمين ابونا ابراهيم الخليل شافي منهم اني بيذبح لابونا اسماعيل ده اسماعيل فقام رب العالمين قال له يا ابتي افعل ما تؤمر تجدني ان شاء الله من الصابرين فلما جاب عمشه وجاب السكينه جاب السكينه بده يذبحه السكينه تنقلب على عفاها
باذن رب العالمين
فرب العالمين بعتهم من السماء
كبش
فدول اسماعيل قال له هذا عواد ابونا عواد اسماعيل هذا فدي وعاد فكله عماش وجابوا الخروف ذبحوا عواد سيدنا اسماعيل
تذبح الخروف انت تذبح الخروف
ايوه انا بجيب الذبح
تذبح الخروف
فهمت قصته يا ابني
مع السلامه
الله يعطيك سلام يا ابوك مع السلامه خليه مع السلامه
When he imposed prayer on the Muslims, Muhammad thought it was normal to pray in the direction of Jerusalem, as did the Jews and Christians. But what happened in reality is that they didn't acknowledge him as a prophet. The Jews fought him, and the Christians turned their backs on him.
Entonces es cuando Mahoma insiste o encuentra la solución.
Muhammad finally came up with this solution, unless it came to him in a revelation, the Abrahamization of his message. This means that it was the same revelation, but he went to the source itself of this revelation, Abraham. This revelation is not Jewish, because the origin of Judaism is Moses and his law. He bypasses the Christians and the Jews, of course, and goes directly to the source of monotheism itself.
It is a fundamental understanding of Islamic thought that what non-Muslims see as the last of the major monotheistic religions, that is Islam, is in fact the primordial monotheistic religion. In fact, there's a famous hadith or saying of the Prophet to this effect, that all children are born Muslim and that it is the parents who make them Jews or Christians. So Islam sees itself as being the original expression of God's will.
He said, "Why should we continue to look upon Jerusalem as our Qibla? The direction of prayer, all we have to do is return to our original Abrahamic Qibla, which is the Kaaba. Since his ancestor by Ishmael was Abraham, and since he was also his religious ancestor, his spiritual guide, as he was for the other monotheistic religions."
A second major consequence of the rupture with the Jews and Christians is what we might call the Arabization of the message. In short, let's say, Abrahamization on the one hand, and an appeal to the source of revelation on the other.
So when Muslims see differences between the Bible and the Quran, or between the beliefs of Jews and Christians and those of their own, they attribute this difference to Jewish and Christian corruption, either deliberate or inadvertent, of their scriptures, and of the revelation that they received from God.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. جلس النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قبل بعثته وبعد بعثته يتعبد الله ويتحنس الليالي ذوات العدد وذلك على الحنيفية السمحاء التي كان عليها الأنبياء من قبله. وبعد بعثته يتجه إلى بيت المقدس أولى القبلتين. لكن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يتطلع إلى السماء ما بين الفينة والأخرى ينتظر أمرا من الله بأن يجعل للمسلمين وجهة تختلف عن وجهة من قبله. جلس 16 شهرا صلى الله عليه وسلم مع أصحابه بعد هجرته إلى المدينة المنورة، يتوجه إلى بيت المقدس، وبينما هو في صلاته يصلي بالمسلمين، وإذا به صلى الله عليه وسلم ينزل عليه الوحي ويأمره بأن يتوجه إلى الكعبة المشرفة لتكون قبلة للمسلمين إلى يوم القيامة. ونزل قوله تعالى: قد نرى تقلب وجهك في السماء فلنولينك قبلة ترضاها فول وجهك شطر المسجد الحرام وحيثما كنتم فولوا وجوهكم شطرة. واتجه المسلمون بصلاتهم إلى الكعبة المشرفة لتكون قبلة لهم وإلى قيام الساعة.
We shall see how in Medina Muhammad commanded two intense battles, putting as much skill into building a city, a public space, and peace between believers as into waging the so-called war against the Bedouin spirit. Muhammad would end his life in Medina.